place harbors a story worthy of an epic tale. From Spanish galleons, Dutch trade ships, and Japanese invaders. Through the centuries, many vessels have docked at these shores, making this small island a large port of history. This is Corregidor.
It's been said that if Manila Bay were a bottle, Corregidor would be its cork. Its prime location made it a perfect fortress of defense for Manila and Manila Bay, and that's exactly how the island was used during World War II. No longer a crawling fortress, but still home to wartime relics, and now museums and monuments, it's an interesting and conveniently located point of interest for visitors to the Philippines, whether you're a history buff or a curious wanderer alike. 30 miles from Manila, at the mouth of Manila Bay, this tadpole-shaped island measures only a mile and a half from head to tail, making it a great destination for a day trip. Sailing the waters just like the soldiers did, boats course from the cultural center of the Philippines in Manila, direct to Corregidor. Only this ride is much more leisurely. Once you're there, board a festive tram, called a tranvia, where a tour guide awaits to take you back in time. Also welcoming you is General Douglas MacArthur, arm extended to the sky with his famous proclamation, "I shall return." It's here that MacArthur uttered that famous line before fleeing to Australia. Former military barracks, about 100 years old, resemble ancient Roman ruins. Japanese aerial attacks hit the island on December 29, 1941, sparking the Battle of Corregidor. Visitors can now march through the rubble that remains. Arms more up your alley? 23 batteries, or groups of guns and missile launchers, are scattered across Corregidor and its neighboring islands. They were key in defense of the island, and only the strongest and most capable soldiers manned them. The oldest structure on the island is the Spanish Lighthouse. Originally built in 1836 and almost demolished during World War II, it was resurrected to its former glory. Museums and memorials also scatter about Corregidor. There's the Spanish Museum and the Pacific War Memorial Museum, which displays interesting regalia of both the Allied forces and the Japanese Imperial forces. Its accompanying memorial was built by the United States in 1968. It's explained that every year on May 6th, at exactly noon, that circle of sunlight perfectly aligns with the altar, signifying the moment when Japan took control of Corregidor and the Philippines. Across the way is the eternal flame of freedom, which burns bright, almost touching the clouds. A more recent addition to the island is the Philippine Heroes Memorial, built in 1987. Through its murals, the memorial honors Filipino heroes not only from World War II, but heroes spanning from the Battle of Mactan in 1512 to the People Power Revolution of 1986.
October 1944.
But perhaps the most awesome and eerie attraction on Corregidor is actually underneath it. They are the island's underground network of tunnels. Malinta is Tagalog for many leeches. Not a pleasant place for the over 4,000 soldiers, nurses, and army wives who dwelled here during the war. But they did so because it was a safe haven from the bombing overhead.
General George Smollett.
Now statues, visitors, and sunlight are all that fill these halls. However, there are ghost hunting tours offered here after sundown. General MacArthur kept his word, returning to recapture Corregidor and the Philippines in March 1945. So next time you return to the Philippines, make a date with history by visiting Corregidor.